Hello, YouTube land, and welcome to another episode of Xenoblade Mondays, right here at the Voice in Unison Gaming Channel. I am your host, Dantes, and today the journey ends. The last of the super bosses is going down, and his name is Reeking Douglas. I just want to thank everybody who have joined me in this journey. I really appreciate all the support, all the comments, people asking for questions. I really like that it has helped people be able to defeat these super bosses. So I really appreciate it. Anyway, aside from that, Reeking Douglas, honestly, is the easiest of the super bosses. You shouldn't have a hard time defeating him. More in this level, and I wanted to fight him in lower level, but by the time I defeated all the other super bosses, I was like, whatever, I'm just gonna beat him on the level that I am, and it's gonna be easy, which sucks, because you like a little bit of challenge. Here, Reeking Douglas just put a little bit of stench, so I'm trying to move Bridget. Get close, so you can finish that combo. There you go, finish that combo. So you can do that. If the monster has stench and puts stench on you, just move your, try to push the blade towards you or towards the driver, and then they can still do the combo. Aside from that, this guy, the only thing you have to worry about this guy is he calls his cronies to the fight. So it can get a little bit hectic at one point in the fight, but at this level, I was not worried at all. But if you're in lower levels, what you want to do is, look at that, seal reinforcements. That's the status alignment you want to put on the monster. So any dark blade combo would do. So basically, you have to finish a blade combo with the element of dark, and I should have done that, and this fight would have been even more easier. But again, like I said, I was not worried. This monster was easy, and more so with my level here, and I was like, yeah, I'll bring the cronies, I'll whip their ass too. So that was kind of my thought process. Here they come. Look at all the aggro. So I quickly switched to Nia, because Nia has high block rate, and even if the cronies keep attacking me, look at that, I keep blocking, and they are no mash for my Nia. And I do have ultimate shield as an auxiliary core on Nia, so I can, you know, deflect some of those attacks. Here I switch to Mithras, I can hit them hard, all of them at the same time. And of course, I'm just now finishing the combo with Poppy Cutie Pie. My build, like always, is a critical heal build. So, hey, every time you hit crits, you're gonna heal. Shouldn't worry. Just bring Nia, just in case you need some healing and blocking. If you again put some high block rate on Nia, I like to put high block rates on my healer blades, so that way they last longer. Anyway, Morak again, same agility. A lot of agility up there. Wasu with Morak. She doesn't hit hard because of I have Pentagon chips on all the blades. But what I do is I put a lot of auxiliary cords that absorb aggro. There you go. Here comes Aegion with the crush shot. Oh my god, and people say this game doesn't have something for the ladies. Look at that, ladies. Some Aegion crush time. Anyway, this guy, Reeking Douglas, you just need to put like 3 to 4 elemental orbs and you should be enough to destroy him. Here I put 4. Switch to the true form of the Aegis just for the hell of it, just to bring down a little bit of pain. And look, you'll see how much pain I bring to Reeking Douglas once I finish this combo. Again, like always, upset an element, try to destroy those elemental orbs. Oof. Overkill start. Magnificent. You know, when the first time I saw the trailer and the narrator was saying catchphrases like that, magnificent, excellent, I was like worried that was going to be stupid in the game, but after once you start playing the game, it just pumps you up even more. And that music in the background, you're rocking on. Okay, anyway, aside from that, let's finish this chain attack with a elemental burst with full burst, baby. So time for Poppy Cutie Pie to lay the smack down on their candy asses. Woo! Roger, roger. Magnificent. Look at that. Look at how much damage output I was able to do with just 4 elemental orbs. So again, you don't need to do much. could have done this. I know you guys have been with me watching all the Super Bosses video. You must be tired of knowing my build. It's typically the same build. I have switched it around. Cutie Pie is the star of the build, but Morak has taken the center stage in a couple of the videos, so go back and watch those videos. We do have a full list of videos for Xenoblade Monday, so you can go back and watch any of those videos. Now I'm just going to show my build, and maybe I'm just going to stay quiet for a couple of seconds. I know it's going to be hard for me, but I'll do my best. Okay, that's enough. Scare you? Anyway, pouch items. Anything that increases my party gauge really fast and anything that gives me recharge those specials really fast, highly recommended. Mithra, you're going to see the auxiliary cores, of course, with increasing that critical rate. Because, again, I'm doing a critical heal build. So I want to hit those crits as much as I can. And then you're going to see Ultimate Shield with Nia with that high block rate. She helps me control the population when a lot of cronies come knocking. Again, with Morak, I know, again, she doesn't hit that hard. But I do put a lot of auxiliary cores there to make sure that I can maintain that aggro. And, of course, the star of the show, Poppy Cutie Pie. I do have a video. You can go back and watch it where I explain how to make this build and also where all the technical manuals are, and also I explain so you don't have to kill yourself playing Tiger. So go back and watch those videos. Anyway, let's start ending this show, and I really want to thank everybody who has joined me in this long quest of defeating all the super bosses. Please remember to subscribe, like, and comment so you can make these two crazy MFs happy. Also, remember, we do have a Nintendo podcast called the Get In and Get Out Nintendo Podcast every Saturday, 9:30 p.m. Eastern Time. You can get that podcast on SoundCloud and iTunes for free. Also, go to the description box below so you can see the full channel schedule. We got content for every type of gamer. Also, we do have a Facebook page called at Forcing Unison Gaming. And finally, and this is finally, go to ChigueroSNews.com and SwitchCar and give some clicks and love to my boy Caliones. With all that said, thank you again. Long live Xenoblade. See you, everybody.